Again, we're so excited about being here as the Lord has led us in the midst of all the things that's going on with the coronavirus. The Lord has led us to just take the word outside the building.
Well, the new normal is really reaching people another way versus footsteps, people coming in the sanctuary. We had to learn pretty fast how to reach people via Facebook, Zoom, conference calls, and all these ways. The coronavirus caused us to think out of the box a little bit. And certainly as a leader, as a pastor, as a shepherd, your first concern is to make sure that your people are safe. So basically that becomes a priority, a safe way of getting the message out. In order to accommodate the crowds that we normally reach, we are now over on our Iberville property and built a platform. We were a little creative, and that's simply the call to try to get everybody who don't feel comfortable coming here to be in an open field where they can remain in their car, get out of their car.
Hallelujah! Listen to this! Woo! Sons and daughters shall be saved.
I'm looking at the numbers, what's happening in, probably in the next month or so, because our economy has opened up. So what we're doing is we're just looking at what's going on. What I'm doing personally, I'm talking to my medical people in my congregation to find out what's really going on with the virus. Your minority groups, black and brown, we started looking around at our own family members and friends. And I have some people that are close to me. One of my best friends, his father died of the virus. So it said to African Americans that we had to be very careful. And I think that when you look at underlying health conditions, whatever's going on, most of your leaders in the black community, because they love their congregation, they don't want to open up this and end up having to bury people. So you're gonna see and we'll find that the majority of your African American pastors, even though other churches are open, we have said, well, hold on, we wanna look at this. And then the design and the nature of how we worship high energy instruments and all of this, the way, just the singing, it's not just hymn book singing, it's out of the heart. You feel it, you sing it. So we recognize that in this type of worship, the level of energy goes throughout the whole congregation. So when someone is singing, the particles, if they have it, could be all over the church. So we recognize that we probably just need to wait, and that's why we're waiting.
Thank you for saving
I've said life. Before this that the church is not the steeple, the church is the people. So wherever we assemble, wherever we gather, whether it's in a building or outside in the parking lot, we want to generate the same level of energy in worshiping God. We brought that presence to the field, which makes us who we are, the Abundant Life Evangelistic Church.
Our God is an awesome God. He reigns forever and ever.